Hey friends, Azure Sentinel reimagines security operations as a new cloud-native solution. But did you know that it's also a security, orchestration, automation, and response, or SOAR, solution? Using Azure Sentinel, you can now automate security operations to reduce incident response times. Sarah Young came all the way from Australia via New Zealand to show us how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, it's Azure Friday. Hi, Sarah.
Hi.
You came from Australia. That's amazing. Just to tell me all about Azure Sentinel.
Yep, I did.
Okay. So I'm hearing a lot of acronyms, and it's already got me confused.
Mm-hmm.
There was SOAR.
Yep.
What did we say that one was? Security operations?
Security, orchestration, automation, and response.
See, okay.
I just got it. Just.
There you go. And then SIEM.
And SIEM, also pronounced SIM, depending on what part of the world you're from.
Okay.
In fact, over here, more so SIM.
Okay.
Is Security Information and Events Management.
Okay. And this is now, these are things that we buy and we run locally, and now this has been moved up into the cloud.
Yes, that's right. So with Sentinel, it's a fully cloud-native solution, so Microsoft takes care of all the infrastructure, and you don't have to build anything, you just have to set it up, create some connections, and do a bit of automation, and away you go.
What is this protecting me from, though? Because security is a big word, and it's a big world.
Yes.
And it can't protect me from everything.
No. So I think in today's environments, there's a lot of different things in people's environments. So you've got on-premise, you've got the cloud, you've got endpoints, there's loads of things. And even really good security operations analysts will find it difficult to pull all of those things together and say, hey, this looks strange, this could be an incident. Mm-hmm. So you need tools that can help you do that. And that's one of the things that Azure Sentinel does, is bring all those different things together, look for anomalies, and then it can detect on that and, you know, send your operations team an email or post on Slack, other different things that you can do. And then they'll be able to act on that. And as we know, with any kind of incident response, you want to try and contain it and stop it as quickly as you can.
Is it up to Azure Sentinel or up to your business to decide what is an incident?
We have some best practices, and we actually have a GitHub with some recommended detections, but they're all fully configurable. So what you define as an incident or anomaly and how serious you think it is actually depends on the business who's using it. They can customize that. But we have a number of best practices and things to be able to start you off with, especially if you're unfamiliar with security operations in the cloud.
Yeah. Now, in the past, I understand that setting up security systems like this involves a lot of physical stuff, racking in
yes.
my own building. But the idea with Azure Sentinel is that there's nothing physically?
No. It's effectively a software as a service, a SaaS solution. So all you need to do is set it up over a log analytics workspace, which we'll do in a sec. And then you just have to connect your data sources, configure your detections, how you see fit, and away you go.
Wow, okay. I mean, that's, as with all software and solutions things, that seems impossible to believe.
Yes, I know. It's very, very easy. That's the whole ethos of Sentinel, because SIEM solutions traditionally have been quite tricky and have required a lot of upfront work before you can do anything useful with them. And so Sentinel's kind of trying to buck that trend and make it easy.
That's pretty exciting, because there were times when you would fly consultants in
yes.
from places as far away as Australia to go and set these things up for you in your building, and you're saying that you can just do it right now in front of me.
Yeah.
All right, blow me away.
Let's do it. Okay, right. So I've set up a log analytics workspace already. So I've got my Contoso log analytics. Nice standard Microsoft.
Very creative.
Yeah, very creative,
nice
I know. So I've already set that one up. All we have to do is search Azure Sentinel, which you'll find in the toolbar. And then we're going to set up that log analytics workspace. So we're going to... Not a log analytics workspace, we'll set up a Sentinel. So
Sentinel sits on top of
yes,
log
it does.
Analytics?
It right. does. So that's why if I click add workspace here, it's going to give me the log analytics workspaces that don't currently have Sentinels set up over the top of them.
All right.
So if I click on Contoso log analytics and hit add Azure Sentinel, it's going to now add Azure Sentinel to that workspace. And that's it, it's done. It's already there.
Okay, so how do I know if the right things are flowing through log analytics? I mean, there might be pieces of my infrastructure that are not being brought together yes. for Azure Sentinel to see.
Yes, so you don't need, so there's two ways you connect things into Sentinel. Mm-hmm. You can bring things in through log analytics, but also there are connectors. And they are kind of like custom parsers. Now, what you used to have to do is write these parsers yourself, and that could be really time consuming. Mm-hmm. But we've already got those connectors. So what I was going to show you was how we connect one of those data connectors. It's really, really easy.
Let's do it.
Okay, so. This is a Sentinel, has got a number of different connectors. This is just a few of them. And let's connect Azure AD. So as I said, normally in an on-prem SIEM, you'd be having to write a parser of some description for this. And all I'm going to do is connect here your Azure AD sign-in logs, hit connect, and
I see.
That's
so
it.
Giving it permission.
Yes, to talk to Azure AD. Now,
and presumably appropriate permissions, read-only permissions, et cetera.
Yeah, it's basically the connector looks down into Azure AD and looks at the logs and the things it wants to. So we've got here sign-in logs and audit logs, so I'll connect both of them. And so now they're already flowing into Azure Sentinel. That's done.
So they flow into Azure Sentinel. Azure Sentinel uses the log analytics as its engine of
yes.
for analysis.
Yeah, log analytics is the engine, because log analytics has been around a little while now, and it's generally used for looking at anomalies or just mm-hmm. querying logs. And so Sentinel kind of enhances that by sitting over the top and being more focused on security operations. But it's great, because if you already know log analytics and you know Kusto,
right.
then off you go. You'll be set with Sentinel.
Ah, okay. Mm-hmm. And what if, do I have to make sure that all of everything is connected in the Azure Sentinel connector way? What if I have an existing log analytics system?
So if you've already got log analytics, Sentinel's looking.
Oh. Okay.
So that you can query that already. So if you've already funneled things in that way, that's great.
Okay.
But the connectors are there for things that we probably wouldn't have recommended previously. You just put in log analytics for the sake of it. So there wouldn't be no reason that you push Azure AD logs into log analytics, because Azure AD already has a store of them.
Exactly.
So that's why the connectors are there.
So if I go and connect all the things, I connect mm-hmm. as many things as I
yeah.
can, wouldn't that potentially make gigabytes or petabytes of flowing data? Or are we just,
yeah.
how many days of this are we keeping?
That depends. It very much depends on how you want to play it. So for connectors, Azure Sentinel doesn't pull everything in. It's kind of just looking at the stores.
Ah.
So we're not duplicating, because we don't want to duplicate data, because that's making people's storage costs go up, and
mm-hmm.
it's not a good idea. So what happens is it's kind of just looking. It uses the connector to kind of see through into there.
Cool.
And depending on the type of connector, sometimes we're only taking up security alerts from certain products, like Security Center, like from... what else have we got now?
Well, what other connectors did you have there?
Oh, let's go back to the connectors. Let's
so
do
you went
that.
To you went to Sentinel Workspaces. Okay,
yeah, so we've got Azure ATP.
Even a generic Azure Activity one.
Yeah, and there's Office 365 and Security Center. So those products actually already generate their own security alerts, and that's done in the product.
Uh-huh.
And so that uses like our back-end threat protection and threat intelligence to actually generate some alerts. So they're already like quite high fidelity alerts. So you could get an alert from Security Center that says, we think this machine has an RDP brute force attack going on against it. And what's happened there is it's already looked at, you know, quite a lot of logs. It'll say, hey, we've seen 20 sign-ins in the last 30 minutes. So it's already done that analysis, and it just sends up that consolidated alert. So that's a lot less information going up as well. So we're not duplicating stuff, and it's actually more likely to be something of note from a security point of view.
Now, this might be a foolish question, but could you perhaps explain or juxtapose the difference between Sentinel and Security Center? Because I'm an existing Security
yes.
Center person, which is kind of a low-key dashboard for me to look at my stuff.
Yeah, no, that's a really good question, because we get asked that all the time. And so Security Center is focused on infrastructure. So that can be in Azure, it can be on-premise, it can even be in other clouds.
Okay.
And what it does is it looks at the behavior for threat protection, and it also is a hygiene tool. So it will score your infrastructure
right.
against the Center for Internet Security Azure benchmark. So,
mm-hmm.
and it will tell you things like, you know, this web app is configured for HTTP rather than.
A friend of mine called it a credit score.
Yeah,
for
pretty
your
much.
Card.
Pretty
yeah,
much.
We
like
a B plus.
We like gamifying security, Microsoft.
Exactly.
Yeah, but and so that's the difference. So it's very much focused on infrastructure, and what Sentinel does is it takes alerts from Security Center. It'll take it from Azure AD. It takes it from all these different sources and will correlate them to look for security incidents. So that's kind of the difference. It's totally understandable why people don't quite understand the difference.
Sure, but now that you've explained it though, sentinel is one who is forever scanning.
Looking over constant, the top of everyone.
It's temporal in that things are happening over time, and it is a sentinel, while the security center is, like I said, more of a recommendations engine.
Yes.
All right.
Exactly, yeah. But it's because it's so new, of course, it's something that people ask a lot, so it's a good question.
Naming things is hard.
Yes.
And then you said that you can create a workflow, like I could potentially have this post into my Teams or my Slack or
yes.
create tickets?
So we can create playbooks. So we use playbooks and logic apps like we do throughout the whole of Azure for automation, but you can also use it in Sentinel. So I'm going to create a playbook real quick and just a nice straightforward one. So I will just call it security. Oh. Let's see if I can spell security alert system.
And these playbooks, I mean, I can share these across my organization.
Yeah, you can. Yeah, if you've created this playbook, as long as they've got access to the resource group that you created in, it'll be there. And it's really nice because playbooks use logic apps, and logic apps is a nice GUI-based interface. So if you're not into coding, I'm not a huge coder, I'll be honest, then you can actually do this with a really nice GUI interface here. So all we have to do, and if you're familiar with Microsoft Flow, then this should look very familiar to you. So we create the trigger. So the trigger is going to be when a response to an Azure Sentinel alert happens. Mm-hmm. And then we'll do, for this, I'll post in Slack. So we just look for these connectors. Logic App has like 250 to 300 different connectors. So I've saved some time here, of course. I've already like generated API keys and connected these to the different applications. But we're going to post a message in Slack. Mm-hmm. And then we just pick the channel name. So I'll connect security alerts. We'll just say, I don't know, help.
Panic.
They're panic. Bad things are happening. We can also just put the bot name in there as well. So we can call it Azure Sentinel, if it's going to let me do that. And you can also have dynamic content as well.
Of
so you can actually pull in the alerts or the time, et cetera.
Yeah.
So you can put in as much information as you need. And it's nice because we leave it very flexible so you can align with all your different incident response processes because companies do things in a different way. And the idea is that we give people loads of flexibility so they can do whatever they want. Also, I'll also create an issue in Jira. So we'll do Azure environment issues, brief description. We'll just have security alert in Sentinel. And we can also send an email as well. Why not? Let's just do the all three. And this is a super, super basic workflow that I'm doing here. There's all kinds of other things you can do as well.
But the point is that you've got playbooks, which is a scalable and wonderful part of Azure that's included. You've got logic apps, which is an understood and includes a huge number of connectors.
Yeah.
And because you're now bringing Sentinel into the mix, you get to use all these other things in Azure to fit into your workflow.
Yeah.
And what I like about this is that it's prescriptive and that it's security best practices.
Yeah.
But it's also not prescriptive because it lets you express incidents in a way that your company expresses them.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm just going to save that. So,
issue type ID.
Oh, let's have a bug. Well, it should be a bug if it's a security issue. So I'm just going to save that. And then just to save time, what we would do normally in Sentinel is we would attach this playbook to a detection trigger. So if it saw, sort of anomalous logins or something, and we could define the threshold and how serious that is. Okay, so now we're going to run that manually just to show you. We'll run the trigger.
Mm-hmm.
And then...
So you're simulating an event here.
Yeah, we're just simulating it just so I can show the playbook running. So we'll just watch that run. And if we look into my Slack now, we can see Azure Sentinel has posted help.
Very helpful.
Yeah, I know. Really helpful. We'll just refresh Jira. And we can see that it's created a ticket for me in in Jira. And then last but not least, I have a panic, security, bad times. So there you go. And again, that's a really, really easy one that I've just done there. But there's lots of different things you can do with automation.
Yeah, if there's not animated GIFs of someone panicking, then I.
If we get a connector for that, I'm there.
Fantastic. So people have this now?
Yes, it's in public preview at the moment.
Mm-hmm. So folks can go and sign up for it now, try it out in preview, and see if it works with their infrastructure well.
Yeah, definitely.
Fantastic. I am learning all about Azure Sentinel and how it's going to make security just that much easier in the cloud and beyond today on Azure Friday.